Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? Birds are somewhat overrepresented in the night sky. Of 88 constellations, 10 of them are birds. I mean, take a look at all of them. There's a bird of paradise, an eagle, dove, crow, swan, crane, peacock, toucan, and a phoenix, which is granted a mythical bird, but still a bird. Wow. Maybe that's because we are conditioned to see birds in the sky. In any case, even beyond those constellations, we apparently imagine seeing birds flying in and among other telescopic objects in the sky too. To find some, let's back up and begin at two of those constellation birds, Cygnus and Aquila. The line made by first magnitude Deneb to Albireo in Cygnus follows a similar line in Aquila from Altair, which is at the beak, and towards the tail feathers of the eagle. A couple points here. One is that the Milky Way, sadly unseen by many of us here on Earth, runs parallel between these two lines. However, a pair of binoculars scanned across here reveals far more stars than you can see naked eye, likely 3 to 4 magnitudes more. Second, a deep sky object. We want to find a third magnitude star at the tail of Aquila. From Altair, scan naked eye or with binoculars or finder scope along this general line and find the Delta star in Aquila, a 3.4 magnitude star 8 degrees away from Altair, just over a binocular field of view. About the same distance, on a nearly similar line, is Lambda, another 3.4 magnitude star. From here, in the Eagle, we are oh so close to some wild ducks. Huh? What's that, you ask? Haha, more in a moment. And now this week's dark sky fact. Full cutoff light fixtures are easy to install, eliminate dangerous glare, and light up what needs to be lit, the ground. Consider changing old, poorly shielded fixtures to modern shielded ones. You can find dark sky approved fixtures at Lowe's home improvement stores. Alrighty, so let's zoom in a bit. At Lambda Aquilae, we are not far from the border of Scutum the Shield. Follow this easy to see trail of stars. You'll hop about a degree and a half each time, each star slightly dimmer than the last. Now, curve back just a tad, and there is Messier 11, also known as the Wild Duck Cluster, due to its triangular shape like ducks in flight. If you do nothing more with binoculars and keep moving past there, you'll be looking into the Scutum Star Cloud, a section of the Milky Way less obstructed by dust, and under darker skies, a brighter region of our galaxy from our perspective. And where Aquila got the short end of the deep sky object stick, Scutum is full of them, with the globular cluster M26 not far from M11, also near this pair of fifth magnitude stars. But that's not our next target. No, this video is for the birds. Wait, that didn't sound right. Anyway, look for this line of stars here that has a little hook or curve near M11. Do you see that? I call it the high-heeled boot. Okay, don't ask. That's what I see, okay? Follow the line of the boot past Alpha, the brightest star near the top of the boot in Scutum, and stay on that line. But watch for this 5.1 magnitude star along the way that is slightly below the line, then this 4.7 magnitude star, which should now be at the edge of your binocular or finder scope field. And guess what is centered? The Eagle Nebula. Do you recall this Pillars of Creation Hubble Space Telescope photo? That was taken here. I'll have more information about these objects along with observing tips for viewing them at eyesinthesky.com this week. At 100 times or more on Venus, a gibbous phase is clearly seen, though look early in the evening while the planet is still above the horizon after sunset. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.